Today's episode is Corduroy and Pinocchio and their classmates from Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and gets ungrounded. And this is a sequel to Eric Cartman poops in Bugs Bunny's bedroom and gets grounded requested by Sally De Palma.
It is a nice day at school today and we are having fun on the playground and building sandcastles with our friends.
I agree with you, Corduroy. Carolee, it is such a nice day at school today. I love being your partner and buddy at school.
Me too, Pinocchio Disney. I love being your buddy and we all love our friends here except the troublemakers like Eric Cartman. Corduroy and Pinocchio are having a good day here at school and so is us. And Julia Young, it was having fun to play on the playground with you, and I love building sand castles with you.
Oh, thank you, Alex Temple. I love playing with you and we also love to build sand castles together, my best friend.
However, you are welcome to my house and play games together, if would you like, and you are my best friend.
That is nice that you offered me to come to your house, thank you, Alex.
Hey Jimmy Buffalo, it is fun playing with you, and especially, I love building sand castles with you.
Thank you, Patrick William Carolee, it is nice playing with you and building sand castles with you, and however you can come to my house, and play games and other fun stuff.
Sounds awesome. I would love to come to your house and play games and other fun stuff, and however, you can go to the movies and see a movie with me and my friends.
I would love to see a movie with you and your friends at the movie theaters. Thank you.
So, Timothy James McCormick, how are you doing this wonderful, amazing day at school?
Everything at this school is wonderfully amazing and awesome. We have nice and kind and caring teachers we love and all of our friends here, including Yushali Temple.
Oh, that is very nice of you, Timothy James McCormick. We love our beloved teachers Karen Miller and Marianne Fisher and all of our friends, and however you and your friends are invited to my house to play games and other fun stuff and watch a movie together.
Thank you for inviting all of my friends and I to your house and play games, watch a movie and other fun stuff. However, you, Corduroy, Pinocchio, Alex, Julia, Patrick, Jimmy, Jack, Jill, and all other of my friends are invited to have a slumber party at my house, and during the slumber party my mother will buy night lights at the Nassau Park Pavilion Home Depot and lava lamps at the Nassau Park Pavilion at Home Store. We will have lunch at the Nassau Park Pavilion McDonald's and play in their play place, and my mom will buy dinner, desserts and snacks at the ShopRite in Nassau Mall. My mother will make and cook the dinner for you and me and my friends, Corduroy, Pinocchio, Alex, Julia, Patrick, Jimmy, Jack, Jill, and all other of my friends from here at school, and it will be a very nice dinner and we will have a special dessert and have a lot of fun during our slumber part at my house, and we will have a good time with all of us at my house. But let me warn you. My house, Nassau Park Pavilion, and Nassau Mall are near a back road called Quaker Road. Quaker Road does flood sometimes because it crosses the Delaware Raritan Canal so low, so there are safety gates with stop signs on both ends of Quaker Road that closes when it floods, and right at Nassau Park Pavilion there are warning signs with flashing lights that say Quaker Road closed when lights are flashing, so you will be warned to not go on Quaker Road when it is closed for a dangerous flood. But at least there is a detour for when Quaker Road is closed, and the detour is Province Line Road, and we do take Province Line Road from my house to Nassau Park Pavilion and Nassau Mall. Good thing there are back UPS.
Oh, thank you about the warnings of Quaker Road as when we have a slumber party at your house.
You are welcome, and you and all of my friends are welcome to my house anytime.
Wow, it is a nice and sunny day and having a good time at school with you and all of my friends, especially Sissy, and good thing Eric Cartman is back in the building with Principal Patrick and some of our friends to help Principal Patrick supervise Eric Cartman to not to leave the timeout chair for being such a naughty boy.
I agree with you, Jack. Eric Cartman must stay in the timeout chair during recess because Eric Cartman is such a naughty boy for doing so many naughty things. And by the way, it is nice playing on the playground with you, and I love to help build sandcastles with you.
Oh, thank you, Jill. I love building sandcastles with you too. You are the best sister I ever had, especially we both have a lot of good friends and good teachers here at school.
You are right, we do have a lot of good friends and good teachers who love us all and takes good care of us all and be kind to us all, and we love them too. Especially teachers must be kind-hearted, caring and respectful to their students, not mean to students and yell at their students.
Yes, teachers must be kind-hearted, caring, and respectful to students, not be mean to students and yell at students. You are right, Jill.
Just look at my students being so friendly, playing on the playground and being good friends and helping each other out, and especially I see them helping each other build perfect sandcastles.
I agree with you, Karen. We all love our students as well. They are so kind and friendly and caring like us, except the troublemakers like Eric Cartman, who does so many naughty things. I even have some of our good students back in the building helping Principal Patrick supervise the troublemakers like Eric Cartman stay in their timeout chair and never leave until further notice. And by the way, you should give them an A+ on these students on their sandcastles, because they are helping each other build their sandcastles extremely beautiful and well-structured.
You are right, Marianne. I should give these students an A+ on their sandcastles because they are helping each other and these sandcastles are beautiful and well-structured. And that is so smart of you, having some of our good helpful students back in the building helping Principal Patrick supervise Eric Cartman and other troublemakers stay in their timeout chair until further notice.
Thank you, Karen. We all do make a good and helpful team here at Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. This is the best school in the planet.
I agree with you, Marianne. This is the best school in the planet.
Excuse me, Mrs. Miller and Mrs. Fisher, may I borrow your students that are on the playground to help me clean up Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom last night?
Of course you may, because we are all kind and helpful and caring and respectful and honesty here at Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus.
And also, while you are at Bugs Bunny's bedroom with the students that are on the playground, you will go back in the building with all other of our good students who are helping you supervise the troublemakers like Eric Cartman and stay in their timeout chairs until further notices, so we and all other of our good students will make sure the troublemakers won't be at it again.
That is a good plan, Mrs. Fisher, and see you two and other students when we get back. Attention students who are on the playground. I got something awful I would like to share with you.
What is it, Principal Patrick?
Eric Cartman, the naughty boy from South Park, just pooped into someone's bedroom again, and this time he pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom, ruining his birthday party plans for his new friend Snap, Crackle and Pop's birthday.
Oh, that is horrible. Bugs Bunny is mine and Corduroy's favorite Looney Tunes character, and now he has poop in his bedroom. That is awful.
Poor Snap, Crackle, and Pop the Rice Krispies elves, their birthday is ruined. And we feel bad for them.
I agree with you, Alex. We feel bad for them.
I feel bad for the Rice Krispies elves and Bugs Bunny, just like my friends. Eric Cartman is such a naughty boy, not a good boy like me.
I agree with my friend Patrick Carroll. I feel bad for the Rice Krispies elves and Bugs Bunny like him and his friends.
Poor Bunny and elves. Eric Cartman needs to learn a lesson.
I agree with you, Timothy. He does need to learn a lesson.
I agree with everybody. We all feel bad for Bugs Bunny and the Rice Krispies elves. Eric Cartman, the naughty boy who needs to knock it off.
You are right, my love brother. Eric Cartman is such a naughty boy and he does need to knock it off, and I also agree with everybody on the playground. We all feel bad for Bugs Bunny and Snap, Crackle and Pop.
I agree with the students on the playground. We feel bad for Bugs Bunny and Snap, Crackle and Pop.
Poor Bugs Bunny and Snap, Crackle and Pop. Eric Cartman needs to knock it off.
But look on the bright side, we will clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water, so Bugs Bunny will throw out Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday party. Who is into cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water from when Eric Cartman pooped in his bedroom?
I love you, Principal Patrick.
Good to hear. Corduroy Karaliaka, Corduroy the Bear, Pinocchio Disney, Alex Temple, Julia Young, Patrick Karaliaka, 2-year-old Patrick, Jimmy Buffalo, Timothy James McCormick, Shirley Temple, and Jack and Jill Baker for willing to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom last night, so Bugs Bunny can throw the birthday party for Snap, Crackle and Pop that he planned last night. This is amazing.
Wow. Our students are so wonderful and well-behaved, and even the ones that are still in the building who were helping Principal Patrick keep the troublemakers in their timeout chair to stop them from making more trouble.
All of my students except the troublemakers like Eric Cartman should have an A+.
I agree with you, Karen. We do have a lot of awesome students and we should give them an A+ on everything.
And before you head back in the building, I would like to tell you that I will see you when we get back from cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom.
Thank you, Principal Patrick, and have a safe trip to Bugs Bunny's house.
Yeah, I agree with Karen. Have a safe trip to Bugs Bunny's house. We will see you when you get back and we will take care of the other good students who are still in the building who helped you keeping the troublemakers like Eric Cartman out of trouble. And we should be heading back in the building now.
Bye, Mrs. Miller and Mrs. Fisher. See you when we get back and take care of your other wonderful and amazing students. Okay, everybody, wait right here's when I bring my Corbell school bus in front of the entrance and then line up in front of the building to get on my Corbell school bus. On my children, when I stopped my school bus in front of the entrance, I deployed my stop arm. The stop arm is the most important part of school bus safety and safety of other public transportation vehicles because the stopped arm is a stop sign on an electric mechanical arm that gives clear warning for other vehicles to stop, and all stop signs are octagon because the octagon shape helps everybody, including people who don't speak English, deaf, colored blind, or can't read, and we are even helping out those people in the modern day traffic. The shape is the most important, not just the word and color. In traffic signs, the shape is the most important, whereas the color is the least important, because out in this world, including here in the USA, there are some people who don't speak English, deaf, colored blind, or can't read, and those people only could use the octagon shape to mean stop, and we are even helping out those people too. Can someone ask me what does the octagon shape means?
I know, Principal Patrick. Octagon means stop.
That is extremely correct, Corduroy. Octagon means stop.
Since that octagon means stop, all vehicles must stop every time when the sign is an octagon shape. And another good thing is that the red light at traffic control lights are being reshaped octagon, so it will be easier for people not to enter on red, because a red light at a traffic control light means you are not allowed to enter, and the yellow light at traffic control lights are being reshaped into sideways trapezoid with rounded corners on the wide end and pointed corners on the narrow end to warn them to slow down. And especially my dad Geppetto does forget sometimes. I always help him and remind him that at a red light, drivers are not allowed to enter, and remind him that octagon means stop and sideways trapezoid with rounded corners on the wide end and pointed corners on the narrow end means slow.
What, Pinocchio, that is smart of you to know of your safety rules and help your dad get to. My creator Patrick William Rich made these new traffic control lights with the easy recognizable shapes, with the red lights reshaped octagon and the yellow lights reshaped sideways trapezoid with rounded corners on the wide end and pointed corners on the narrow end, and all of the better traffic solutions. We all should thank my creator Patrick William Rich. He is the greatest entrepreneur like Walt Disney was, and when we get on my school bus to clean Bugs Bunny's house, we must get on one at a time for safety, and I will call and count your names as you walk by me as when you get on my school bus. Jack Baker, Jill Baker, Timothy James McCormick, Shirley Temple, Corduroy Karaliaka, Corduroy the Bear, Pinocchio Disney, Alex Temple, Julia Young, Patrick Karaliaka, 2-year-old Patrick, and Jimmy Buffalo. And we are ready to go to Bugs Bunny's house to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom. Here we are at Bugs Bunny's house. So is anyone ready to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom?
I will clean up his bedroom. Since that Bugs Bunny is my favorite Looney Tunes character.
Me too, my favorite principal. And I agree with my friend Pinocchio. Bugs Bunny is the best Looney Tunes character.
Can't wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom, they'll be excited.
I agree with you, my sweet amazing brother Jack. I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom along with Corduroy, Pinocchio, Shirley, Timothy James, Alex, Julia, Patrick, and Jimmy.
I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with my friend Shelly.
I agree with you, Timothy James. I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom as well.
I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with everybody here.
Me too. And I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water too.
I will definitely help Principal Patrick and my friends Corduroy, Pinocchio, Jack, Jill, Timothy James, Shirley, Alex, Julia, and Jimmy to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom.
I agree with you, Patrick. We definitely help Principal Patrick and all of our friends here to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in his bedroom.
Well then, let's do this job all together. Holy cow, this poop has got to be another of the worst Eric Cartman has ever made, and this is just as bad as when he pooped in Mickey Mouse's bedroom. Stand back out of toilet paper to pick up this poop and flush it down the toilet. Stay with my cleaning stuff I bought at the Home Depot and don't move.
Preview.
I came back in from flushing the poop down the toilet and washing my hands. Is everybody ready?
Yes.
Then let's clean all together. Did a really good job today. Now it is time for us to go back to school, which is Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus, because Bugs Bunny will be back here soon.
I hope I get to set up my new friend Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday party. Something smells nice and clean and soapy in here. What it could be? Well, someone have cleaned my bedroom with soap and water from when Eric Carrington pooped in my bedroom. Now I'm going to check on my security camera to find who have cleaned my bedroom with soap and water from when Eric Carrington pooped in my bedroom.
Here we are at Bugs Bunny's house. So is anyone ready to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom?
I will clean up his bedroom. Since that Bugs Bunny is my favorite Looney Tunes character.
Me too, my favorite principal. And I agree with my friend Pinocchio, Bugs Bunny is the best Looney Tunes character.
Can't wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom, they'll be excited.
I agree with you, my sweet amazing brother Jack. I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom along with Corduroy, Pinocchio, Shirley, Timothy James, Alex, Julia, Patrick, and Jimmy.
I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with my friend Shelly.
I agree with you, Timothy James. I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom as well.
I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with everybody here.
Me too. And I can wait to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water too.
I will definitely help Principal Patrick and my friends Corduroy, Pinocchio, Jack, Jill, Timothy James, Shirley, Alex, Julia, and Jimmy to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in Bugs Bunny's bedroom.
I agree with you, Patrick. We definitely help Principal Patrick and all of our friends here to clean Bugs Bunny's bedroom from when Eric Cartman pooped in his bedroom.
Well then, let's do this job all together.
Now, Corduroy and Pinocchio and some of their classmates from Future Generation Daycare Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus were the ones that cleaned my bedroom from when Eric Carrington and Naughty Boy from South Park pooped in my bedroom along with their beloved school principal Patrick. I cleaned my room as well. I'm going to call their parents about this, and I'm also giving a special reward to Principal Patrick at Future Generation Daycare on the first floor of Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey as well. First I'll call Pinocchio's parents.
So Geppetto, my love, where are you going to open your new workshop at?
My new relocated workshop will be located at 1200 MacArthur Boulevard, number 304, Marwa, New Jersey, 07430, replacing Boggin Communications Incorporated, because Boggin Communications Incorporated made that nasty PA system called the Multicom 2000 systems that killed the education industry, because Boggin Multicom 2000 bell tones are haunted chimes that sound like a steam whistle which frightens people in our schools and made people hate school and not want to go to school, which is a terrible thing, and especially schools with a Boggin Multicom 2000 system allow teachers be mean to students and yell at students and destroy their toys and belongings, and allow parents be mean to their kids and destroy their belongings and yell mean words and phrases at their kids as their punishments, which are extremely bad and abusive. And schools with a Boggin Multicom 2000 system also allowed scary, inappropriate, abusive anger imageries such as freaky spiky eyelashes and triangular eyes, which are abusive caricatures that make little kids cry extremely bad. And we know that people cannot yell, scream, make freaky spiky eyelashes, triangular eyes, aim guns, destroy people's toys and belongings, say mean words and phrases, nor any other scary inappropriate behavior no matter how mad they get.
You are right, Geppetto. Cannot yell, scream, make freaky spiky eyelashes, triangular eyes, aim guns, destroy people's toys and belongings, say mean words and phrases, nor any other scary inappropriate behavior no matter how they mad they get. And teachers must be kind-hearted, caring, respectful, and honesty to students, not yell at students, be mean to students and destroying their toys and belongings, and how parents must discipline their kids as calmly put them in time out and talk stern to them about what they did wrong and how to behave better, just like Jiminy Cricket did to your son. Not be mean to them and destroy their toys and belongings and yell mean words at them, which is abusive, not a punishment at all. But good thing is that Patrick William Rich is recovering the education industry forever by having them bring back electric mechanical wall bells, green chalkboards and Corbe school buses, and only happy and friendly and safe and school appropriate things like Corduroy the Bear with two buttons on his green corduroy overalls, nursery rhyme posters, and Walt Disney's animated films Snow White and the Seven Dwarfs and Pinocchio, etc., and only allowing kind-hearted and caring and respectful and honesty people to be teachers, and having all mean teachers that yell at students, be mean to students, and destroy their toys and belongings, be cleaning servants in brick and mortar stores, pick up trash around the road to recycle them into new things, and other boring jobs. And schools are now banning the bad things like mean, scary, inappropriate, abusive, mad behaviors like what Frankie Foster had in her show Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, which is why her show Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends have ended for good, and all Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends leapfrog games and products are now rethemed with Walt Disney's animated film Pinocchio, because Walt Disney's animated film Pinocchio does have a lot of good real life lessons by listening to grown ups. Never talk to strangers, avoid temptation, etc.
You are right of all of what you said. Walt Disney's animated films Snow White and Pinocchio are way more school appropriate than Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends, and good thing that Nelvana and PBS Kids have acquired Cartoon Network and Hanna-Barbera, and Nelvana is restoring Hanna-Barbera back to their most popular classic looks from the 1950s and 1960s and getting rid of Foster's Home for Imaginary Friends for good. And it is a good thing they are bringing back safe green chalkboards, electric mechanical wall bells, corporal school buses, and all other good things from the past. And I can wait to open up my relocated workshop.
Or I can wait for you to open up your new relocated workshop too.
Oh, that must be my phone. I must answer who is calling me. Hello, Geppetto Disney here. Who is this calling me?
This is Bugs Bunny speaking. Your son Pinocchio has cleaned up my bedroom with soap and water, along with his best friend Corduroy the Bear and some of his classmates and his school principal Patrick from Future Generation Daycare, Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus.
He did what? Wow. He is such a good boy, along with his best friend Corduroy and his classmates and his principal Patrick from Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Sarah and I will unground Pinocchio when he gets home. Goodbye.
Sarah, my love, my son Pinocchio cleaned someone's bedroom with soap and water again. He's such a good boy, along with his friends and classmates from Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. You were right, Geppetto. Our son Pinocchio is such a good boy, along with his friends and classmates from school, which is Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus.
Next, I am going to call Corduroy the Bear's parents.
From what I heard at the meeting last night, Eric Cartman just pooped in someone's bedroom again. I hope his parents will teach him a lesson.
I agree with you, Moppy. Eric Cartman needs to knock it off, and he needs to stop pooping in people's bedroom. Eric Cartman is such a naughty boy. But anyways, I hope today tonight will be a better night, and I hope someone cleans Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water from when Eric Cartman pooped in his bedroom, because Bugs Bunny is planning a birthday party for his new friends Snap, Crackle and Pop, the Kellogg's Rice Krispies elves.
I hope the Rice Krispies elves Snap, Crackle and Pop will have their birthday party tonight. Oh, that must be my phone. I must answer who is calling me. Hello, Moppy Carolly here. Who is this calling me?
This is Bugs Bunny speaking. Your son Corduroy the Bear has cleaned up my bedroom with soap and water, along with his best friend Pinocchio and some of his classmates and his school principal Patrick of Future Generation Daycare, Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus.
He did what? Wow. He is such a good boy, along with his best friend Pinocchio and his classmates and his principal Patrick of Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Lisa and I will ungrant Corduroy when he gets home, and Lisa and I will also ungrant 2-year-old Patrick too. Goodbye.
Now I will call the other kids' parents.
Corduroy the Bear, good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom in soap and water with your friend Pinocchio and some of your classmates and your school principal Patrick at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friends Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. Producer Ungrounded, and 2-year-old Patrick, you're ungrounded too, because you cleaned Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water, along with Corduroy, Pinocchio, and some of the classmates with Principal Patrick.
You both now can do whatever you want.
Thank you, Lisa and Moppy. You are the best.
You are the best.
Pinocchio, Timothy did a good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with your friend Corduroy and some of your classmates and your school principal Patrick of Chamberlain University, North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friends Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. For the ZR, ungrounded.
You can do whatever you want. Thank you, Bunny and Sarah.
Timothy James McCormick, good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with your friend Corduroy, Pinocchio, and some of your classmates and your school principal Patrick of Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friend Snack, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. For this you are ungrounded, 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 ungrounded. You can do whatever you want. Thanks, Mommy, you are the best. And I even invited Corduroy, Pinocchio, Alex, Julia, Patrick, Jimmy, Shelly, Jack, Jill, and all other of my friendly classmates, which are my best friends, for a sleepover here on Friday night. Of course, all of your friends are invited to a sleepover to our house, and in fact, we will head on to Nassau Park Pavilion and buy stuff for the sleepover with buying nightlights at the Nassau Park Pavilion Home Depot and a beautiful lava lamp at the Nassau Park Pavilion at Home Schools, and head to the Shoprite and Nursery Mall to buy stuff to make a wonderful dinner over during the sleepover and dessert and snacks for the sleepover. We can go shopping now.
Jimmy Buffalo, good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with your friend Corduroy, Pinocchio, and some of your classmates and your school principal Patrick of Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friend Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. For this you are ungrounded, 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 ungrounded.
You can do whatever you want. Thank you, Mommy and Daddy, and I love you very much.
I love you too, Jimmy, and you are a good boy like Corduroy and Pinocchio, and especially your friend Timothy James McCormick invited you and all of your friends to a sleepover at his house. Jimmy and most of his classmates are such good kids.
I agree with you.
Jack and Jill Baker, good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with your friend Corduroy, Pinocchio, and some of your classmates at your school principal Patrick of Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friend Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. For this you are ungrounded, 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 ungrounded.
You two can do whatever you want, and you may play outside.
Thank you, Mommy and Daddy, you're the best.
Julia Young, good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with your friend for the red, Pinocchio, and some of your classmates, and your school principal Patrick of Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friend Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. For this you are ungrounded, 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 ungrounded.
Your father and I are so proud of you for helping your friends clean and working all together with all of your friends at school. You now can do whatever you want. Thank you, Mommy and Daddy, and I love you, and you two are the best. Love you too, and all of your friends at school, like Corduroy the Bear and Pinocchio, and most other of your classmates.
Alex and Shirley Temple, good job for cleaning Bugs Bunny's bedroom with soap and water with your friend Corduroy, Pinocchio, and some of your classmates, and your school principal Patrick of Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus. Now Bugs Bunny can throw out a birthday party to celebrate his new friend Snap, Crackle, and Pop's birthday, which was yesterday. For this you are ungrounded, 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 ungrounded.
And as for you, Grace and Robert Temple, you are ungrounded too for helping Principal Patrick supervising the troublemakers like Eric Hartman to stay in their time off chair until further notice and make sure they don't cause trouble again. You four can do whatever you want.
Thank you, Mommy and Daddy. We all love you.
Today at the playground, my brother Alex and me heard that Timothy James McCormick is inviting all of us, including the classmate of ours that stayed in the building helping Principal Patrick supervise the troublemakers, to stay in their timeout chair and not cause trouble, to have a sleepover at his house this Friday, and you two are invited as well.
A sleepover at our friend Timothy James McCormick's house? I am excited. I can wait to visit my friends Timothy James McCormick and play games, watch movies at his house, and have a good dinner his mother will make for the sleepover, and I just can wait to see you, Alex, Pinocchio, Corduroy, Patrick, Jimmy, Jack, Jill, Jim Jr., and all other of the good hard-working classmates at our school Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus, with our beloved teachers Karen Miller and Marianne Fisher.
Because at Future Generation Daycare at Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus, we all help each other do our part, spread kindness, and take responsibility, and take respect. Especially Chamberlain University North Brunswick, New Jersey campus is in a new modern 21st century environmental friendly and clean building that has been in use since the late 1990s.
And I am excited for the sleepover too. And what my sister Grace said a second ago is all true, and she is right all about that.
Good job, Grace, for sharing good information about our school and what an amazing building it is. Let's head on to our rooms and play some games.
Yeah, games. I love playing games with all of you.